हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एनालॉग आईएएस प्रीलिम्स हाई यील्डिंग सीरीज फॉर प्रीलिम्स 2020। एंड द टॉपिक फॉर टुडेस वीडियो इज नेशनल गैस ग्रिड। इन आवर कंट्री द वुमेन बेयर द ब्रंट ऑफ ऑल द डेवलपमेंटल प्रॉब्लम्स। फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ यू टेक द केस ऑफ कुकिंग गैस, मोस्ट ऑफ द रूरल हाउस होल्ड्स डोंट हैव एक्सेस टू क्लीन कुकिंग फ्यूल। एज अ रिजल्ट दे आर एक्सपोज टू सम हार्श कंडीशंस एंड जनरली many women have developed cancers because of lack of access to this cooking gas. So as a measure towards empowerment of poor women in the country who are denied this access to clean cooking gas, the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas has previously launched Pradhan Mantri Ujjwal Yojana in the form of a social movement. So this has enabled a social change, and the sustainable use of the scheme and continuous access will ensure that empowerment of women will continuously take place. Apart from this, what are the other activities taken up by the government to increase access to cooking fuel and in general natural gas? So national gas grid is one such objective. What is the objective? It is very clear: to remove regional imbalance. There are certain parts of the country, say for example you take East India as such. Many states in this part of the country do not have access to cooking fuel. So as a result, they are still stuck in that conventional mode of cooking where they go for chullas or burn wood for cooking their own food. So in order to overcome this problem, the government has decided to connect gas sources to major demand centers in various parts of the country. So as a part of this, they want to build the city gas distribution networks. So what are the features of this national gas grid? So at present, there are 16,000 kilometers worth gas pipeline networks in the country. However, the recent budget decided to expand it to 27,000 kilometers. The objective is pretty straightforward. They just want to increase the share of gas in the energy usage. So at present, we only have 6.5% of the share of the energy market through natural gas. They want to increase it to 15%. So for special focus on the eastern part of the country, the government has come up with Pradhan Mantri Urja Ganga project. So there are also other parts of the country like the northeast India which do not have access to clean cooking fuel. So for especially those areas, Indradhanush Gas Grid Limited is the company which is going forward with this idea of Northeast Gas Grid. So they have a viability gap funding from the government. What is viability gap funding? The government will fund that part of the project which is not considered feasible for carrying out it economically. So the government has a vision or a larger plan which is called the Hydrocarbon Vision 2030 for the Northeast region. The single point agenda of this vision document is to increase access to clean cooking fuel to empower people. So they want to reach out to more and more remote corners of the country. So a gas pipeline which is about 750 kilometers would be going through Bihar to Assam. So this is the main point that you have to remember. Now, which of the following states have not been covered under the Urja Ganga gas pipeline project? So, like I've mentioned, the emphasis is on East India. So, Jharkhand, Orissa, West Bengal, all these states have access to this project. It is Chhattisgarh that does not have the any share in this particular project. So, Chhattisgarh is the answer. Now, have a look at this question. Please pause the video and comment your answer in the comment box below. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching it.